Salutations! This is WindWolf88 bringing you another Let's Play, this time of a game that hasn't been played in a very long time and has been in hiatus forever, which is Roller Coaster Tycoon number 1. I do believe last time I played this I left off with Leafy Lake, which I renamed Wolf Lake, and now we're going to be continuing on to Diamond Heights. So let's go ahead and see what this park's about. Alright, Diamond Heights. The objective is to achieve a park value of at least 20,000 dinero at the end of October year number 3. Alright, so basically we need to double the value of this park. Let's go ahead and see. Okay, Diamond Heights. Not gonna do. Makes me think of Hacienda Heights. Not my favorite town in the whole wide world because my car always seems to overheat or break down or do something down there. Let's go ahead and rename this. I don't know. What are we gonna name it? Given the lovely... Oh, this is actually a really sizable park. Let's go ahead and call this... Looks like a bay. Let's call it Wolf Bay. Oh, yes. Because I'm that original. And if this place gave out stuffed animals, it would be little wolf plushies because they're so cute. Alright, let's go ahead and see. Park rating is 830, so it's not too bad. Guest and park are 558, and we have an admission price, which is free. Alright, so a lot of stuff is arachnophobia. Alright, so apparently this park has spider problems. And we have no awards. Okie doke, so I think each of these rides are probably charging an admission price by themselves. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Yep. So I don't really feel like making the park admission free if each ride is already charging money to get onto it. It would be a lot of work and I'd lose a lot of revenue if I did that. So let's go ahead and just leave those as they are. Let's take a look at how many staff we have on. We have, what, 4 people? We do. Alright, so let's go ahead and hire more handymen because I bet you with a park like this we're going to throw up everywhere. And I, for one, do not like going to a theme park and stepping in vomit. It's disgusting. I don't like dealing with it. It's a biohazard. Goodness knows what was in their stomach before they regurgitated it. So it looks like a big chunk of my monthly revenue is going to get cut by my staff, but it's a pretty sizable park, so I'm not terribly worried about that. Let's go ahead and hire a security guard. Alright, people are hungry and can't find anywhere to get something to eat, so obviously there are no places or to buy something or any venues. No. Nuh-uh-uh, that's not gonna fly. So you guys are not gonna mow grass. There's no point in it. Let's go ahead and check to make sure my other handymen are not going to be mowing grass. Because that defeats the purpose of... Alright. Cool. Anyways, I know how to clear the grass anyways. You just go ahead and you get your shovel tool and you click on it and it goes poof, no more grass. So apparently guests are hungry. Let's see what we've got here. We have Snake River Falls, which was a log plume. We got... Did I click on the right one? No. Arachnophobia. Alright, so we got people who are phobic of spiders. Okay, so apparently this park is the stuff of nightmares because apparently somebody was very phobic when they decided to make this. I think I'm going to start changing names. Well, at least the train lets off back here. See, Roller Coaster 1 is very unoriginally named. Then you got a slide and a carousel. Alright, not too shabby. Just no places for anyone to eat. I don't like the train. Let's see, let's go ahead and rank ride popularity. Popularity sort. Snake River Falls cluster. Yeah, 20%. Let's go ahead and remove that. It's kind of taking up a good chunk of... Well, it's not really taking up a good chunk of space, but I like more in the front of the park. This ride sucks, so we're gonna go ahead and delete it and tick off a whole bunch of people. Plus, I can use the money to put better things in there. Wow, I got a lot of money off of that. So let's go ahead and delete this pathway. I hope I refunded those people. It's just like, oh, sorry, you paid good money to get on this ride, and I just deleted it from out from underneath you. Yay, I'm nice. So let's go ahead and get rid of this and this, and we're going to delete these trees in the front of the park, because as you might know, I'm obsessed with trees and vegetation and having a cheerful-looking park. So let's go ahead and people are leaving. That's never a good sign. Let's make it pretty so they don't want to leave. Right? Maybe? No. Alright, so we need to go ahead and figure out that food crisis. I don't really want to put food menus in the front of the park, but this wouldn't actually be a bad place to put it, given... Actually, this is a good little chunk of land over here, just a lot of trees. Okay, so what I'm going to do is we're going to make the front of the park look super snazzy really fast, because that will bother me unless I do something, and then we'll start working on getting those food venues up and ready to go. So let's go ahead and... Yep, trees. I'm obsessed with trees. But I like trees, and I wish I had trees that look like this where I live, but no! I had to live in a desert, so that's not really going to happen. Yes, I still live in the desert. And it's beautiful, and it's 109 degrees right now, and I don't really want to go outside, because I'm a wimp. And I like being in air-conditioned buildings, so I really want to go camping and hiking, and no one wants to go because it's hot. So what we're going to do, I think, is I'm going to turn this into a food court back here until I figure out what to do later with this land. So let's go ahead and, yeah, I'm going to use my shovel tool, but I want to optimize this space right here. Okay, it's not horribly detrimental to my profits, just slightly. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and... Okay, cool. Let's go ahead and get rid of that, and then we'll... Well, that was stupid. Oh, man! I suck at this sometimes. Alright, so let's go ahead and put a bathroom in, because I'm sure people's bladders are going to get to the point where they're about to explode. And we'll go ahead and put the food court in as well, so people can grab a bite to eat. I don't really want to put ice cream. I think it's kind of a waste of money right now. And I'm going to go ahead and put the information kiosk, what is right here? Right here. We're going to open that up, and we're going to go ahead and open up the food venues as well. That way people can grab a bite to eat. So let's go ahead and get those up and running. Let's go ahead and call bathroom, without a one, because that makes it look tacky. And we're going to call the pizza place Pizza Factory. Pizza Factory. Oh man, I haven't been using a keyboard that much lately either. My computer skills suck right now. Okie dokie, so we've done that and that, and we're good, and we're going to make places for people to sit. So apparently everyone's starving and they want food. You people, who needs food? It's like sleep, it's for the weak. Who needs sleep? I do. Alright. Yes, yes, I need to put it on the pathway. Yeah. Alright, so we're going to do this. Get these people soupsies. That was an even bigger oopsie. Get these people situated so they can eat and not be so miserable, because apparently they didn't bring their own lunch, or I don't allow people to bring their own lunches. And then we'll go ahead and... I like these better. They look cuter. Oh yes, because you need to worry about stuff looking cute. And I guess we'll put some trash cans in so they can deposit their waste. And give my handyman something to do. Alright. And I guess I'll put some cute flowers and stuff. And then we'll get to the rest of the park eventually, right? Right. Okay, okay. So let's go ahead and do our trees. And then we don't have to worry about feeding people for a while. I will be putting some other stuff up in the back of the park too. So that way they don't have to worry about exploding bladders and other things of that nature. Yay! We're the best value park in the country! No! We're not allowed to be the best value park in the country. That's not a good thing. Which means I need to jack up my prices, like Disneyland. Because they totally don't do that to loyal pass holders. Not at all. And I suck with a mouse, too. Yay! I'm on a roll right now! And I'm wasting money! Not good. Oh, wow. Builds character, right? Right. Everything builds character. Okay, and I'm sorry if I'm kind of snipey towards Disneyland, but they raised their pass prices again, and I'm not terribly thrilled about that, because I don't think it's very nice. But then again, I don't run a theme park, and I guess, you know, $700-some isn't enough for a park pass, right? Actually, I don't feel like increasing the queue on this for now. We're going to leave it be. Let's go ahead and change Snake River Falls. No, we're going to rename this. So it's not the Step of Nightmares. Let's call it Cooper Canyon Falls. Because that's something that pays tribute to something nearby. And let's go ahead and make this white with... I don't remember what my color schemes have been for previous games. I think I did blue. Let's just make it a light brown. Make it look pretty. Give it a new paint job. I'm sure people would appreciate that. And we'll just leave it be for now. I don't really think anyone's going to be getting nauseous off this ride either, but just for the sake of comfort and security, we're going to go ahead and put that anyways. We'll do this. So that way it looks pretty as they come in. And I want to be able to see through my scenery so I can see if I need to put benches because people are probably going to sit up there with pizza later. This guy's depressed. He needs a hug. Maybe kittens. Kittens solve everything. And then these people are eating. The information kiosk is selling umbrellas, so we're going to be in the good here. Let's go ahead and make our scenery non-transparent and go ahead and pan out and see what else we have. Now, apparently this one's called Arachnophobia. What are we charging for it? $4.50. I'll leave it at that for now. Let's go ahead and change the coloration, though. It makes me think of spiders, and I think they're cute, but a lot of people don't. And I don't want little kids coming here and be like, oh my god, Mom! This is the Park of Nightmares! We're never coming back! I want good word of mouth. So let's go ahead and make this a different color as well. Let's do something light. Festive. Have we done green? I don't know. I don't care. But it's gonna be green and yellow. With yellow supports! Ooh, pretty! And we're gonna do... white seats with green car. Alright. There we go. That's a nice little freshening up of the paint job. And let's go ahead and change the name of the coaster. I'm trying to think of something snazzy. I'm working on that. Why not? Sure. Let's call this the Mountain High Express. I don't get away from this even during the summer. Alrighty, so we have the Mountain High Express and Cooper Canyon Falls. So if anyone, you know, likes to go hiking or is into skiing, you guys know where I stole those names from. Let's go ahead and look at the rest of the park too, because I'm kind of neglecting it while I'm working on the front here. We do have food vendors. We're good. Got a bathroom, so people's bodies aren't going to explode in the front. Not so much the back, because this is a big park. I'm thinking of consolidating more of the rides into one more central location, although I don't want to have everything clustered in the front. Let's go ahead and turn the park this way. Make use of this little plot of land. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and clear away a bunch of trees. And make the land look pretty. Pretty. Alright. I can plan this out pretty easily. I think what we'll do, if they have some more gentle rides and stuff, I'll... Whatever. You guys can find the pizza place in the very front of the park. You just have to walk 6 miles to get to it. Deal with it! It builds character, too! Everything builds character. Obviously, they don't go to Magic Mountain. That's a lot of walking. And it's totally exciting, unless you wear bad shoes when it's not so fun. Alright. A drink stall. Let's go ahead and build that since we're near the awesome food court. This one doesn't have signs. Huh. Alright, so where are the trees? We're going to go ahead and plop a drink stall. We're going to call this Cactus Juice. I think. Yeah, why not? Okay, so they're all going to be on hallucinogenic drink. Alrighty! That's awesome. Let's go ahead and build ourselves some attractions. What do we have here? Swinging ship, a bunch of little coasters, we already have a carousel, and a slide. Already pulled that out, got a lot of money for it, so that's good. So let's go ahead and plop ourselves down a nice little haunted house. So that way we can start getting people on a gentle ride, because I'm not certain everyone has a decent nausea tolerance, and they might start exploding in wonderful world of projectile vomits. I don't really want to be around to witness that. So let's go ahead and open this up too. Haunted house. Trying to think of something. What's that house? Oh, wait, no. It's the one up on the corner behind the restaurant. It is... Did it belong to the Weekleys? Yeah. Beakley! The Beakley House. And we're gonna charge an admission price of $2 for this. Because it's scary, and there's freaky stuff in that house, and there's this old abandoned house that's behind a restaurant that I like going to in my town. And it's been there since like the 1920s, 30s, but it's been abandoned for ever since I can remember, actually. And I've heard stories about like murders and other weirdness going on in there, so I don't try to stay away from it. But I still want to go poke around, and apparently it has a really deep well in the basement. And it's really weird for houses to have basements out here, so I'm just like, yeah, no. Alright, so let's go ahead and put you right here. And we're going to go ahead and put this way and go down. With sound effects, because sound effects are always awesome. And we'll make it come out this way. And then we're going to go ahead and... Wow, I'm glad there's a gigantic electrical storm going on right now. And I can't remember. There we go. Yay! I remembered what to do. Kind of. Short stuff slide is broken down. Can we call that short round? Yes! That'd be awesome. Alright, and then we got this whole happenstance taken care of. Let's call this... I don't know what we're going to call it, but we're going to call it something. Claustrophobia is broken down. Swinging ship. Swinging ship. I don't have a swinging ship. Let's go ahead and call this the Queen Mary. Why not? It runs into things, right? I think it ran into something. It had a gouged a smaller ship back in its prime. But anyways, I think it's red and black, so let's do black and red. Ooh, this stands out. And we'll leave the yellow. Make it look pretty regal. And we're going to go ahead and charge $2 for this ride as well. Yay! Alright, and no one's riding it because of the electrical storm. That's okay. I don't blame them. I wouldn't want to be on this ride during the electrical storm either. So we're going to go ahead and do our usual thing with trees, because trees are awesome, and they don't get old. And I can't see what I'm putting back there. And I can't put anything right here anyways, so... No, my voice is going away. I need to stop eating chocolate and drink more liquid. Alright, so let's go ahead and just leave that as it is, except it's more trees. Because trees make the world go round. At least in my world they do. They're pretty. And somewhat functional. And shroud everything in mystery and darkness. I can't even tell there's a pathway there. No more trees. Let's go ahead and put a bench too, because people are going to start barfing all over the place. So now that I think about it, I probably shouldn't have put a swinging ship ride near a food menu. But, didn't think about it too much. Just have to deal with it now. Put these here, and that there, and this here, and voila, we're good. Let's go ahead and section this off too, so people don't have to deal with watching people barf all over the place. Skip. Cool. And then we'll start working on the other parts of the park. Making the park look pretty one step at a time. Spending half my allotted funds on trees.